Hey everybody, I hope you're having a fantastic day. There are so many Arduino weather station projects out there, but so few of them measure wind speed. So when Banggood.com asked me what I wanted to take a look at, I wanted one of these wind speed meters or anemometers. And so this thing with my example code is super simple to use. And as you can see here, I have an Arduino, and this is basically an Uno. It's in a cool package. It's the RGBDuino, which Banggood didn't supply this, but they do sell them. And the RGBDuino is a cool board. They come in a couple different varieties, and they've got little LEDs down the side and, you know, some RGB LEDs here, and just really like using these. They're smooth on the bottom, just kind of slick little boards. So I've hooked up to this Arduino this sensor. Now, the sensor is a little different than some of the other ones because it takes 12 to 24 volts to power the sensor itself, and then it's going to output 0 to 5 volts. So we've got three wires. It'd be a little hard for you to see here, but we've got three wires coming out of this thing. There is a brown wire, which is going to be 12 volts, and there's a blue wire, which I actually have hooked up here to the analog zero of the Arduino. And then the power supply that's giving me my 12 volts is sending ground here and to the sensor. And that's the black wire on the sensor. So very simple, three wires hooking the whole thing up. And what it does is a little bit different than some of the other sensors. A lot of these types of sensors, like this is a water flow sensor, they have a little Hall effect thing in here that is a magnet spinning around. And so essentially with something like this, you have to count the number of pulses over a given period of time. And that's good, except sometimes you miss some pulses and it can be a little bit annoying. But this thing is awesome because it works like a little generator. So essentially it puts out between 0 to 5 volts, and with a little formula, the actual voltage that the thing is putting out will tell you your wind speed. So that makes your code easier and your calculations way easier. And of course, I'm going to give those to you down in the description. So if I were to turn this thing on here, I have to get the fan going a little bit. So as you can see, I've got the fan on it, and as it speeds up, the wind speed and voltages are going up, and we're getting the output on the serial monitor. And so it is as easy as that. And again, because we are taking a voltage reading and not a number of pulses over time, like this thing, we get an instantaneous reading. And I have a delay of 3 seconds in there, but you don't need that. You can have a delay of 20 milliseconds if you want, or no delay at all, and get as accurate and as quick of a reading as you want to get. And so this thing is super simple to use. And with my code, you can get up and running in a couple of minutes.